Well, I was pretty much in tears during our trailer reaction for a ghost story. I'm straight up crying, man. That's unreal.
That's one of those movies
that's gonna straight up get a fish watching. You're like, well, I feel physically and emotionally damaged after watching that. And I can tell you right now that there was a lot of tears during this film. I am still struggling to cope with this film. It's really come out of the cinema with me. It honestly just looks straight up ridiculous.
What does?
You in this getup. Look at it.
Who's you? How's I'm it? A ghost.
Oh my goodness. So David Lowery directed A Ghost Story. He also did Pete's Dragon most recently, and he did Ain't Embody Saints. And he is the man, the myth, the legend, the ghost. Man, are you going to contribute anything? Or are you just going to sit there with a sheet over your head the whole time?
I'm using this to conceal the fact that I'm still crying underneath.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
So I'll be right with you in a second.
And look, if I see a better movie this year, or at least a movie that I like more than this, I'm going to be really surprised because this movie is straight up phenomenal.
Like, it really is quite something. And I want to start when we talk about it. Basically, it's about, we have this couple behind us, Rooney Mara and Casey Affleck. Casey Affleck passes away and basically his ghost comes back and kind of haunts this house. And it's not a horror movie. I think a lot of people get the idea that this is a horror movie. Yes, it had some horror elements, some scares in it that actually made me jump more than I think I've jumped in a horror movie in a long time. But it's more a meditation on life, love, and death. And when I say meditation's a really important word here, because when this film ended, the audience we were with, they all pretty much got up straight away and just started asking questions. What did this mean? What was happening here? What was happening like that? And I think the important thing to address with this movie is that it's a movie that you need to be able to absorb and understand at the same time. So if you're someone who's prone to watching a movie and going, oh, I don't quite know what's happening here, and then spending all that time trying to work it out and not being in the moment, it's not going to work for you. You really have to be able to understand the film so that you can remain in the moment. You basically can't have that analytical part of your brain and the part that kind of absorbs experiences, I guess, happening at the same time. Your brain needs to be able to process what's happening so that you can stay in the moment with it. Because this is more about the experience than what it means or the themes or anything. Everyone's gonna kind of get something a little bit different from this. And some people, yeah, for those of you guys who watch something and go, they need to understand what it meant. It's not gonna work for you. But for us, who are able to sit there and go, okay, we understand what's going on, we understand what's being shown to us, let's just stay in that moment and see where it takes us. You do not get movies better than this.
One of the most beautiful experiences of my entire life. I'm not kidding, like within the first 15 minutes, like I was drifting somewhere
else. You knew
it was
something,
I know,
hey.
It sounds stupid, but like when you see this film and you can experience it and you can sit there and literally meditate and just enjoy what's happening, you will be transported elsewhere. Cause like, yeah. I honestly was unaware of my body for so long of the film, and it was just such an amazing experience. And it was one that needed to be felt in a cinema.
Yeah, yeah, I think you wouldn't necessarily get the same thing watching it at home. It really is part of that cinema experience. And look, like, it sounds like we're like spaced out while watching it or whatever. It's just the fact that this movie is on this kind of higher plane when you're watching it. Like, it is one of the best cinematic experiences I've ever had, because mm-hmm. that's what it's about. It's about being an experience. You're not going and getting cheap thrills or quippy kind of dialogue. You're not going for a couple of casual laughs and you pack up and you go home. The idea is that you go and watch this movie for the 85 minutes it runs for. You take it all in and you take it with you, and whatever you get from it, that's what it's about. Just taking something from it. And I think, like, it really is, it's so stunningly put together as well. Like, honestly, you were saying, like, seeing a film that's this patient being made, I mean, this is one of the rare movies that felt like it was longer than it was.
Yeah.
And not in a bad way, just because you were so, we were so there with it.
Larry has created, honestly, such an incredibly patient film. Like, you have to sit there and wait with it. And essentially what, like, the patience of this film allows it to do is it allows it to both sit in time and travel through time. And it doesn't confuse you whatsoever. So literally you can just be in a moment and you can share that moment with these characters on screen, or you can jump years down the line and you just, you're not put off by it, you're not confused by it, you just go with it because of the way this story is structured.
Yeah, and the world is so beautifully built. I mean, you look at the core concept here, you've got Casey Affleck walking around in a bedsheet, like that old classic I'm a ghost type of thing. And at no point did I question that. I just completely bought into it. The world is so well constructed. It's kind of insane. Like, world building is so rarely this good, especially in a film that's this kind of low budget.
And everything works in with one another as well. And like, just touching on some technical. So for example, like the aspect ratio of this film is, it's kind of like this square, but the edges are rounded. You'll see that in the cinema when you're watching it. So it kind of looks like a little photo.
It's almost circular. There's no beginning or end.
And because like he uses like, you know, like some beautiful imagery the entire time, but like, there's a lot of long takes here, and long takes on images like this one, like you're seeing behind us now. This is just a, like, the camera just sits there on top of the couple, just kissing for like quite a long time. When it cuts to black, that image is imprinted on your eyes and
burns
like
it in.
That's an experience. Like that right there is an experience felt in the cinema, and the music, unbelievable.
One of the best soundtracks I've ever heard.
And it's
like,
both diegetic because it's working within the film, and then also kind of works outside
over the
of
top.
It.
And that's really, really insane. And the camera just tracks and pans, and it follows and it moves and it zooms. And it's always about bringing you closer or taking you further away and controlling how you feel in that moment.
And by God, the performances here are spectacular. I can't tell whether they're working within the script at times or whether it's improv or what the hell's happened on set. I'm sure we'll find out in good time, but the performances are magical. Rooney Mara is honestly... She makes everything look so goddamn easy. It's so frustrating, but it's so beautiful. She's honestly like watching a flower grow on
she
screen.
Just is,
like her character here pretty much gets squashed, and then we watch her grow and leave. And then Casey Affleck, I mean, he's fantastic. Whatever you think of him outside of it, I'm talking about his acting right now. He gave another incredible performance, and you know, it's just a testament to Larry and the script that he can work that well underneath the sheet.
He's under a bed sheet the whole time. That's a film I want to know how he was directed, how it came across. Like he's pretty much in the bed sheet the entire film, and it's like, how am I feeling so much character, so much emotion from just that? That is incredible directing. And there's scenes here where we've got to say, like, there's an infamous scene that's already been thrown around called the pie scene. It is going to test audiences' patience. But if you understand what is being done, it is the single greatest depiction of grief I think I have ever seen. Yeah. Like, it was absolutely stunning. This is a movie that you can't go into with expectations. You can't go in wanting something from it. The only thing you need to want from the movie is an experience. You need to sit down and let this movie take you where it's going to. Otherwise, you will not get out of it what we have been able to get from it.
Because
you need to give yourself to it.
Especially with the themes it deals with, being, you know, it was so heavily with life and death. Like, it just depends on how you sit morally and ethically as to how far you connect with it.
Yeah.
And both of us, like, we both kind of agree with what the film presents here, so it kind of took us...
We don't agree, we're just cool with, like...
We're cool with it, we're open to it. Yeah, and we really enjoy what they're talking about as well, so, like, we could go on that journey. And if you don't enjoy what they're talking about, that's fine, but it doesn't mean you have to dismiss what the film's about either.
Yeah, you can't just put up walls and say, I believe this is not for me, because that's not when a movie's going to work for you like this. And this movie is something that I really want everyone to take in and absorb, and not sit there and question it. Just take it for what it is. People could come up to me and go, oh, what did you think this meant? What do you think this meant? I don't care. I don't want to analyze it. I just want to take in what I have from it, because it was something beautiful. It was one of the most richly engrossing, rewarding experiences I've ever had in a cinema. It's one of the best films I've ever seen. I can honestly say it's in my top 20 of all time already, and I only saw it a couple of days ago. That is how great I thought this was. I think for both of us, there's no other score that we can give it than the highest.
Yeah, it's a 10.
It's a 10.
It's
like,
a 10.
Honestly, and there was a point there I was watching it, I was like, well, can we push the scale past a 10?
Well, I think within the first 2 minutes it hit a 10 and I was like, well, where do we go from here?
Yeah.
We're only going
it's,
up.
It's
not
it's
going
not
down,
worse.
It's going
I mean,
up.
And honestly, yeah, just this is the film of the year at the moment. Like, what a stunning piece of cinema. just, yes.
I'm struggling.
So that was our review of A Ghost Story. Have you seen it yet?
Did you like it? Of course you did.
There's a problem.
But did you like this video?
Of course you did.
Are you craving more banner?
If so, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel by hitting that thing there.
And don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter, all at Breaking Banter.
Hell yeah.